Hello everyone.
Welcome to Hema's home and garden in USA.
This year I couldn't make any garden tour due to various reasons, and this is going to be my one and only garden tour of the year. And today is August 31st, 2022. We are almost in the end of summer season, and here as soon as we enter inside, we have basil plants. This is the Italian basil and toy basil, and my sage plant, and this is the wormwood plant I have, and this patch is my raspberry patch. Here on the other side we have a sweet potato plant that's growing in a container, and this is the galangal plant. We have some chilies here. Galangal is used in Thailand in their everyday cooking. It's like a ginger for them, not exactly ginger, it's something similar. And here I have a tamarind plant. This I grew from seed, and this one is pirandai. In English we call it adamant creeper. So this is my lemongrass plant, and behind that lemongrass plant, this is my moonflower vine. So somebody gave me few seeds and I had one sprouted, and I didn't know where to plant it, and I planted it here, and I didn't expect it to grow crazy like this. So now you must be wondering how this patio area came. The whole thing you see here now, this was not there before. We constructed it only during the early spring, and I'll make a separate video about it, or I will share additional details later in the video. And this is my compost bin. So this is where it is since the beginning. And next to the raspberry plants here, I have some basil growing. So it was, this place was having some cucumber plants before, and once the cucumbers were done, I sowed some basil seeds in a container and just recently transplanted into this area. So this is my blueberry, and this huge monstrous plant that you are seeing is my gongura plant, and it has grown so big, it's almost more than 10 feet tall. And next to the gongura, the whole area you see all along the fence line, this is my goat trellis. In this area I have a garden bed that is not very wide, as you can see here. So this is not a wide garden bed, it is just 2 feet wide and it's 20 feet long. So in this area I had my garlic growing before, and only during the middle of June I harvested my garlic and then I planted these god plants. You can see the ridge gourd just started flowering. Most of the plants here in the trellis were directly sowed after the middle of June, except for the snake gourd. And this bitter melon, the mini bitter melon and the white bitter melon, both I bought the seeds from Seeds of India website, and it has started producing pretty quickly. Oh, next to the bitter melon plants, I have an ash gourd growing. As you can see, ash gourd, I did not let it climb on this trellis because I knew there was not enough space for all the plants to spread. So I decided to let it grow on the ground. But even then, it started holding to certain things and started climbing up. So here you can see this is my blackberry plant. It has dried. So this ash gourd plant has started holding on to the blackberry plant, and it still climbed onto the trellis. So even this ash gourd plant, I sowed the seeds only after middle of June, And it started producing very quickly. I couldn't believe it already have the fruits.
That's two fruit in a stone. So coming back to the patio area, let me show you the plants there. So here I have some herbs growing. This is my thyme and here is my maruvam plant. Maruvam is nothing but the sweet marjoram you call in English. So I bought this one from Home Depot. Next to that I have some rajanikanda plants, some tulsi, jasmine varieties and kanakambaram plants. So basically all the tropical plants that I would take inside during the winter months, I have kept it here in this area. And here I have the sanajaji plants. It's another variety of jasmine that blooms in the evening. And next to that I have my Meyer lemon plant, and the Meyer lemons will be ready during December. And next to that I have a betel leaf plant. On the other side here, I have some rose plants. These roses are very prolific. It always keeps blooming and I am never out of roses. Look how beautiful these are. And this orange one, this is a climbing rose variety and it always blooms in clusters. I always get to harvest huge clusters of roses whenever I need. You can see how big the cluster is. And coming to the other side of the property, this is where I have the other fence door, and here I have a huge retaining wall that's all along the property line. Here I have some more tropical plants, everything in containers. Since I couldn't put a garden bed here, I'm growing most of the plants in containers. So here I have the Indian broad beans, henna plants, bay leaf plants. And few more tropical plants like orange kanakambaram, made of New Orleans jasmine, bell of India jasmine. So most of my tropical plants that I can grow only in containers, so they are here. Next to this jasmine, I have a sugar cane. So this one I have been growing since last year. I'm not sure if I would be successful growing it to its full extent. Anyway, I'm trying. If I get successful, I'll definitely post here. And this is my Thindora plant. So whatever is in the retaining wall, it's all growing in the containers. So here I have four containers of ginger growing. And this is my tropical fruit trees like papaya, banana, fig. And this is my turkey berry plant and my moringa plant. It just started flowering. I don't believe I'll get any moringa fruits this year. And this is my pineapple plant and this is my kumquat plant. So this is the first year here. I bought it during the winter month and it started flowering and I see several fruits here. And this is my passion fruit plant. I'm not sure what variety it is and I don't see any flower buds in the plant so far. So that's all about the containers. And coming to the fruit tree area, here we have the pomegranate and fig trees. So these were two trees that were planted in 2017. So this fig tree has given us so many fruits so far. Even now there are so many ripe figs in this tree. So this is such a prolific fig variety, and the figs are absolutely delicious, and it grows so well in our area too. And next to the fig tree, I have this persimmon tree. Last year we had a blast, and this year we had to prune our persimmon tree. And next to the persimmon tree, here we have a peach tree. We had to do some disease control in our peach and replanted it from the original place. So this tall tree, this is a pear variety. And next to the pear, here next close to the fence, we have an apple tree. And here we have a pair of cherry trees. So cherries, it just started producing. Coming to the other fruit trees, this is our plum tree that I planted earlier this season. And this is a new variety, new addition to our garden. This is a jujube variety. This is a Chinese variety of jujube. In India, we call it regipan. And this one is the dragon fruit, a new addition to our garden this year. And this is my Satsuma orange tree. So that's all about our fruit tree area. And let's see about the garden bed areas where I grow vegetables in ground. So the first bed, we have some chili plants. So these chili plants were on the retaining wall. I had to bring it to this garden bed after I harvested my onion. Initially, I had my onions here. So when after harvesting the onions, I planted some peanuts here and then also brought those chili plants and put it here because it was getting too hot. I had no other choice but bring it to this garden bed area. And the second garden bed, I have a mixed variety of peppers, including poblano, sweet bell peppers, Thai peppers. So many peppers. We used to harvest a huge basket full of peppers every week. I also have around 20-25 plants of okra here. So this garden bed is completely with a different varieties of peppers. And the third garden bed, this is the last garden bed I have. Here I planted tomatoes initially and it grew so beautifully. It produced lots of tomatoes, and by the end of May, it got disease. It got affected by the tomato blight virus, and I had to pull all those tomato plants. And then luckily, I had some pepper plants. So I put all those pepper plants in this empty space, and luckily the blight did not seem to affect the pepper plants. So I also have some guar cluster beans plants here. So they are growing very beautifully. They are producing abundance of cluster beans. So this is only just 4 plants I have, and it has like branched out so big and it's producing like crazy. So that's all about my 3 garden bed area. This is the overall area of my garden. This is the overall area of my backyard garden. You see here. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and if you think my videos are useful, if you think my videos are entertaining, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and also please hit the bell icon so you receive the notifications whenever I post a new video. Thank you all for watching.